To draw a portrait, we start by drawing a circle, then a line down the middle, dividing the face in half. Afterward, we outline the curve of the hairline and the chin, connecting the two to form a curved plane that can be likened to a piece of paper. Afterward, we draw a line perpendicular to our first center line to divide the face into quarters. Then by drawing features on the face represented by simplified planes or shapes, which form three-dimensional forms, we can avoid flat face syndrome. First the nose, then the cavity created by the brow and the eye sockets, which we draw as one shape partially bisected by our nose. Next, we carve out the basic outline of the face and some terrible looking lips. Don't worry, they get better. Then immediately after, we outline the hair and begin working in smaller and smaller shapes as we slowly move away from representations to more accurate depictions of the features of the face. Make sure to start shading to help define the three-dimensionality of the face, while simultaneously removing line work wherever possible to be replaced by shifts in value, as this will make our drawing a bit more true to life. Now that our portrait is starting to look like an actual human face, we should flip the canvas to more easily spot any mistakes and continue to render it out, focusing on areas where the face feels flat or misshapen. On another layer, I quickly covered the whole face in a light gray with my brush, and then erased parts of it to add highlights. Afterward, I made some random floating shapes to put behind his head because it added some visual interest. And now you might be thinking that we're done, but of course we're not done because we're missing the critical element that every portrait requires, which is the car. So let's hide this bad boy and sketch out half a vehicle, which we will then skillfully attach to his face with surgical precision as we slap them together with the elegant instrument known as the move tool. Lastly, we need to give our man some hands to drive his new automotive augmentation and maybe make him a bit melty. And now we're done. That's how you draw a perfectly normal portrait. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to comment down below, like the video, and subscribe if you want to see more content like this.